sense. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10-10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go to it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Houston Oilers and the New England Patriots. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. After a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Play fake. Here's Love, rolling to his right. Wide open receiver complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. A little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play and gave up a bigger one instead.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Now a handoff looking right. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a 3rd down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
About a yard, if that. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard.
4th down and 1.
Love to throw for it on 4th. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. The conversion is successful with a sizable gain of 13, and the decision to go for it looks like a smart one. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Now they try the right side here. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Play action this time with Love. He'll buy some time right into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against, an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football, But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Second and six.
Successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
Third down.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. And he will take this down to the 10-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the seven. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there, but of course you're going to give it to him.
And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the nine. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Love from the gun. Steps away to his left. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Pats have taken the early lead.
If you did know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now he can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Now this will make it into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
And 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Open man, it's Rager. He's got it. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
A gain of 12. First down, Houston.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
With the score, Patriots 7, Oilers nothing.
First down carry by Jones. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
No gain.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
They'll find Paris Campbell. That's complete. And this won't be enough. A good secure tackle, and they stop him a few yards shy at the 46.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Naeem Hines, his first carry. And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive.
And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Naeem Hines. His second touchdown on the season. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And they drew up the counter there. It worked. They're glad they drew up the counter.
And a lot of times what you're trying to do is just simply get the defense moving in one direction. Doesn't take much. Even one step's enough. Get them going in one direction and then cut back against the grain and let your running back finish it off and get the work done.
So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
Over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him, as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arc on it, he's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play in football.
They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation.
No gain on the play. Brings up third down and nine.
The shotgun, it's Love. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16.
The 11-yard line.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
A gain of a yard.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at seven.
reminder coming up just a few minutes from now. We'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Now a handoff looking right. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway because that's your strength.
Third down, Love. This will be caught at about the 5. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The Patriots will bring on the field goal unit. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this game will remain tied here in quarter number 2. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you're not going to have too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. He was trying to find Noah Fant, the tight end. And now it's second down.
Second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Sliding out of the pocket. He'll run it. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Oilers. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. They'll find Hines out of the backfield. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last 2 plays.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down. They'll set up a throw. This is the tight end Fant. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Another strong gain on the last 2 plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number 1. Try and run for it on first and goal. And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Nyheim Hines as the first half is winding down. And his guys have taken the lead. Oh,
Well, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taking it about the one. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
Patriots take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. We're under 20 seconds to go in the half. I'm guessing the wise play here is be safe.
That is the wise play, because if you think about trying to fool them here, here's what you're facing. You're facing a loosened-up secondary, playing a lot deeper than normal. So even if you run some type of misdirection, you're only going to fool them for a second or so. And guess what? They're so deep, they're really not going to be out of position. Take the knee, get to the locker room.
First down, going to the air with Love. Dancing to his left. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
Thrown away and incomplete. It's second down and 10.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Throwing again. Love. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. That one good for 10 yards. And the Patriots will get a new set of downs. Final play of the half, Love. He sets to fire deep. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So we have reached halftime in what's a six-point game at the break. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone, and the half will begin with a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. They'll go again to Jones. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
On third down, Hines. And he gets this all the way down to the Patriots' 12-yard line. It's a big play there on third down. 54 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes the defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He'll look to throw. Fine work by the Patriot D there, and it's fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And now it's a two-score game at 9, 16-7. Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps the deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. On play action, love to throw. And now he's going to use his legs. So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating? The guys who just gave up that play.
Off the play fake, Love. Rolling to his right. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Love, they go play action now. He'll buy some time right. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
First and 10.
25 yards that time. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Now an option play on second down. Love fires that quickly outside. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Well, one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. DeForest Buckner in on the tackle.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Working out of the gun, Love. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And the ball is knocked out, and this will be scooped up by the defense. Well, there you go, from red zone to red zone on that fumble return.
It's amazing how fast things can turn around, isn't it? I mean, it looks like one team's driving, got everything taken care of. All of a sudden, the ball's on the ground or popped in the air, and whoosh, There you go in the other direction. Good job by the defense. You see how they practiced that, too. You can tell, coordinated. As soon as they got the ball, everyone turned to block someone and tried to help him along the way.
And now set up here, terrific field position. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. A great play there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Pats take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Point after, right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. That last touchdown has made this really tight. They're clinging now to this slim lead. Second half, they only have a field goal. This offense needs to kick it into gear.
And right now, I'm looking directly at the field general, at the quarterback. This, to me, he's got to take over right now by word, pumping his team up, and then, of course, by deed with his play. My high school coach used to say that all the time. Laddie, take over by word and deed.
Indeed means action.
Exactly.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. The offense on 3rd down tonight, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. They run the counter. It's Hines, and he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line.
He'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Levi Wallace with a pick.
Good
enough. He takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. This game, it's been defensively oriented on both sides, so I guess it stands to reason that the play of the game comes on defense.
So it's my kind of game. You know that.
That's
anytime
right.
We have
that's
a defensive right. battle, but that, as you said, it stands to reason that's the way the game tilted. Someone had to make a big play, and the way the defenses were dominating, that's exactly what we got.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is up to 5. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they have to try and move past that pick 6 because now they're dealing with a fourth quarter deficit. And they need this drive to end in points. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
It's a gain of 8.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
They'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on 3rd down. Him in stride, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An effective 10 yards there takes us back to 1st down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
11 more on that one, and another 1st down.
A gain of 11.
I think that's a big pickup for a 1st down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a 1st down, executed it to perfection. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
Levi Wallace.
4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game.
2nd and 3. at the 40-yard line.
So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now the second down throw on target. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
First down, Houston.
They run the counter. It's Hines. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left.
At the Patriots' 24-yard line.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. They'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Jalen Reagor is the intended receiver,
but now it'll be third down. He was unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
It makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here? Or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And that is incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
He's back to throw. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this one's going to go out of bounds, so no recovery. But on fourth down, a change of possession anyway. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They run the counter. Hines. And he's going to bowl his way down to about the one-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Second and goal from the one. They'll try to run with Hines. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Nyheim Hines. His third touchdown of the game and fourth on the year. And his guys are going to retake the lead. So now an extra point doesn't help much. They'll try to go for two to make the difference a field goal, and they can lead it by three. They'll look to throw, and this is caught, and it's a three-point game. So that effort gives them a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about, not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock, so tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. A gain of six there on first. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Throw. Gonna the right side here, complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 15 yards on the play, first down. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Here's Love, escaping the pressure right, and he'll complete this one to Berrios, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Love looking to throw, flush to his right, and he's got his man in stride, complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They had no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times have we seen it happen where you know it, yet a guy's still looking for a timeout or trying to stay in bounds? He got it done.
Sliding out of the pocket. Complete. The tight end, Kelce. All that for a 2-yard gain, second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. Now here's a timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to potentially send us to overtime. That is no good. Wide to the right. And this score will stay right where it is.
Pressure kick, and I thought he was going to hit it. I thought we were destined for overtime, but not the case.
Not at all. And they were already planning for the overtime you just mentioned, already saying, okay, what are we going to do if we get the ball? What happens on defense? Instead of that celebration and that little bit of euphoria, it turned into letdown city.
So Houston gonna come away here with the victory.